Thank you, Tanakaji. First, I just want to assure you and assure everyone inside this hall that one of the lessons which I had learned from my father was give peace to his soul, was that there will be multiple opportunities which will arise in the country where you will be perpetually tempted to exploit that opportunity. GST is one such opportunity for them. And we have, the lesson that has been taught is never to exploit the opportunity, but only to serve it. And my promise to all of you is we will not exploit it. I would love to take the opportunity which I have been given to tell you what we as a company are doing and how prepared we are going to be and how prepared we are going to make the businessmen of the nation and the chartered accountants of the nation. But I don't want to take that opportunity today because there's a short time. I want to use this opportunity to actually make a very fervent appeal. We are sitting in a moment of history. A few months from now and for the rest of the years thereafter, India is not going to be the same. You have heard it from Talatiji, you have heard it from Bhatnagarji. This is a transformational moment for the country. We must congratulate the government for the first time bringing out law in a consultative environment. I must very bluntly and candidly say, I don't think they are getting the benefit of the approach that they have taken. Enough of us as Indians have got so used to the fact that we have to live with our fate and not shape our destiny that we are not participating enough in the consultative framework. I have been the most optimistic person as far as GST is concerned about what kind of change it will bring, what kind of ease it will bring, and what kind of transformation it is going to bring. It is the equivalent of creating one of the best ball bearings for business lubrication. If a ball bearing is not working very well, you can oil it, you can grease it. But if it has got even a few grains of sand in it, it does not matter how much oil or how much grease you put into it. The GST law, the model law as it has been framed so far, and the consultative approach which has been getting used, has got not more than 5-8 pieces of sand in it, and not enough attention and not enough seriousness is being represented to eliminate those pieces of sand. And the only profession in the country who is most qualified, most experienced, most trusted, most capable of giving independent view, most capable of participating in the drafting are the people sitting in front of me. If today you read the draft law, and if you believe that that draft law elements, which are those 5 or 8 grains of sand, have come into existence in spite of your participation, the country is in deep trouble. That if the chartered accountants of the nation can accept such lacuna, then the businessman has no hope. That is the appeal which I want to make to you all. Bhatnagarji talked about running out of time. Yes, 1st April itself is too near us for you to prepare as far as the benefits to your profession is concerned. But there are less than 4 weeks left to ensure that the right law comes out. That is just less than 4 weeks. If you take the fundamental problem of input credit and the government is seized of it, and the government is wanting to correct it, and I must personally tell you that I have never been more impressed with the responsiveness of the government and the willingness for the government to listen, and have never seen a more frustrated bureaucracy where they have been seeking participative advice, and all that people are giving, like I am giving right now, is only criticism and advice rather than participation of correction, which only you all can do. So if you take even a simple aspect like input credit, linking it to money flow, is an impossibility for a small trader to follow. And it is an easily resolvable problem. But they require help from you all. If you take the basis on which advances are going to be considered, it is not going to be possible for any small business to be able to follow and comply with that law. If you take any two location organization and the way the input service distribution is going to take place, there are just 5, 6, 7 simple changes which you all understand better than anyone else. But you all are all, honestly, I'm happy here representing. I am not seeing that same sense of urgency. I am not seeing the same sense of concern. I am not seeing the same sense of participation. And here is an organization who technically should only be concerned about providing the software which the law asks. And the more complex the law is, it is better for me. But the reality is, it's not good for the country. And what is not good for the country can't be good for you. So that's the only movement which I wanted to use. 100% accuracy, but please read the modern GST law. It's a brilliant law in its intent. It has got a few grains of sand which you all must help the government eliminate before it is too late. You can duplicate the law in the future. You can't remove the grains of sand in the future. It is almost impossible. Once it is out, it is going to become chaos. Please help them to make it right so that the country can become, achieve the greatness that it is capable of. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Just a brief note on